Hello, welcome, welcome to the Agris Woodard home. Yes, you're speaking to Yara Ben-Emmett, a.k.a. Keith Woodard. I've been called worse, but anyway, welcome to the Torah Watchman channel. We're talking about Sukkot, and we're talking about dwelling like our tribal ancestors of old, yes, and the Sukkah. Yes, you can see the Sukkah. Yes, Jews love camping outside and outdoors, but for me, this Jew, a little bit more contemporary, my ancestors, I actually transformed a gazebo into a sukkah and made it halakha compliant. Here, my daughter wants to sit with me and she knocks my head off. Anyway, I just want to point out a few things for you. Just deliciously sweet to me. Anyway, a lot of people have different interpretation of what Sukkot is and what it's not. First of all, it's 7 days. It's a high holiday. Why? Because it is as written. That means Moshe said, or God said through his prophet Moshe, you will do this for seven days, for an eternal, for generations to come. Not only to his generations, but to us, yes, in the diaspora, right? We have the lulav, we have the etrog citron, which is like a lemon, this big yellow, delicious, you feel like sour and bitter things, you know? It's a lemon, all from the Middle East, everything comes from Israel. The four kinds is a mixture of palm, willow, like tree branches and things of that nature. It also has the etrog, which is a symbol. It's a symbol of something you can eat, okay? I'm not eating lulav or etrog on my table today. But I do have some wonderful food because my wife is a master cook. Anyway, I just wanted to point out a few things extra. Yes, I always like extra. I always mentioned before and I began that many people think about Sukkot in different ways, okay? I was talking to a Jew today, reminded her, the reason why we even celebrate this Feast of Tabernacles today, that goes all the way back to the time of Moshe, goes back to the time of King David, King Hezekiah, King Solomon, is that, remember, when our ancestors were wandering in the wilderness of sin, literally, for 40 years, they did not have a permanent dwelling. They have mud houses, mud brick houses. Who likes that? In fact, this is a kosher bamboo roof here, and it will leak if it rains, okay? It's not intended to be permanent. It's temporary. That's the whole point. If you read in the prophet, a blessed memory, Ezekiel, he was talking about Gog and Magog. I don't want to get into Bible prophecy right now, or the other things that Christians talk about in their book of religion. What I want to point out, Gog means roof. Yeah, like leaky roof. Yes. The people that don't like Jews so much in the future, the days of Mashiach may come quickly. They will give great armies for the land of Magog. Yes, Gog will lead his armies against Israel. He will fail, long story short. I'm sorry, I like to spoil ending. But what I'm pointing out is that Jews have faith in things we cannot hold and are tangible. We have believed in the cloud of glory, the Shekhinah, which some Kabbalists say is feminine for God's more nurturing, mother-nurturing aspect on the way he takes care of his children, right? But we put our faith in the heavenlies, in the skies, in the clouds of glory, and of Shamayim, not in a temporary leaky roof, considered Tower of Babel scenario. And that's all the Jew has to say about that. Anyway, Yom Tov, everyone choose to listen. Welcome to Yara Ben-Emmett's YouTube channel. Please click subscribe and like and personal notify. I will invite all your comments. Please, thank you so much for joining me in my home. I wish you could smell the delicious food. But anyway, it is what it is. Take care. We're having lots of Simcha, a lot of joy, it's Sameach, happiness, and all this stuff. Anyway, it's wonderful to be Jewish. It's wonderful to celebrate, traditions that are more ancient than me. Yeah, isn't it amazing? Shalom Aleichem, and I'll see you real soon.
The Maldim, the holy things of God, all the holy things, Makarei, Kodesh, the callings of God, good tidings of God for all the festivals. Baruch Hashem, Baruch Hashem, Baruch Hashem. Hope everyone has a wonderful holiday, Yom Tov. Take care. Goodbye.